Good morning, all of you. Welcome to you all in today's fourth online session of chapter number 10. And as we know already, the name of our chapter number 10 is Play with Patterns. In our previous session, we studied some patterns in shape, in numbers, and in colors. Now today we are going to see one magic square, and after that we will discuss about the magic triangle. So let us start our session with magic square. Do you know what is magic square? Let us see. In the magic square, you can see here, in this square, there are three rows and there are three columns. Now you have to put the numbers in this square like that each row, each column should be same. The sum of each row and column should be same. So, some rules are there for this. So, let us discuss that one. If your number is in this box, if you are write down any number in this box, then you have to move diagonally right hand side. So if your number 1 is here, then you have to write down number 2 here. If your number 1, if you are write down number 1 here, then you are write down number 2 here. Means we have to go right hand side diagonally. After number 2, we have to go here. So here our number 3. And you have to write down the continuously number. Now if you are write down here number 1, then you have to move on right hand side diagonally upside. So this is the first rule that you have to apply. Let us see. If you are write down here number 1, then just move upwards right hand side. So here your number 2, then again move upwards, then you have to write down number 3. Second way, if you are write down number 1 here, then just go right hand side upwards. So here you have to write down your number 2. If you are write down here number 1, then you just move upwards, that is the number 2. So this is the first rule. You have to just go right hand side diagonally. What is your number 2? Rule number 2. Let us discuss. Your rule number 2 says that if you are write down here number 1, if you are write down here number 1, and as per the rule, first we have to move upwards, right hand side diagonally we have to move upwards. But you see here nothing is there. So what we have to do? So the next rule is that they says that you just go down, directly go down. So here you have to write down number 2. If you write down here number 1 and just move right hand side diagonally, but you can see here our square is not there. So we have to just move left hand side. So here you have to write down number 2. If you are write down here number 1, then we have to move right hand side upwards, but here nothing is there. So we have to just move left hand side, and then here you have to write down number 2. This is your rule number 2. So let us see. If we are write down here number 1, then we just go down. And here we have to write down number 2. If we are write down here number 1, then you just see in the right hand side diagonally there is a no box. So we have to just move left hand side. And here you have to write down your number 2. This is your rule number 2. Now let's discuss rule number 3. Your rule number 3 says that if in this box, in this color box, you are write down any number. When you move right hand side diagonally, at that time already some number is present here in this box. So what we have to do? We have to just move down and then just move diagonally. Right hand side diagonally we have to just move. See here, if we are write down here number 1, then according to the rule, we have to just move right hand side. Rule number 2, nothing is there, so you have to write down here number 2. Now again right hand side, move, nothing is there. So in the left hand side, in the first box, you have to write down number 3. Now just to move diagonally, but here already one number is here. So what we have to do? We have to just move downwards. That is our rule number 3. So after 3, write down 4, then move diagonally number 5, then again diagonally number 6. Then after, see here, right hand side nothing is there. So rule number 3 you have to apply, and below number 6 you have to write down number 7. Then again rule number 2, right hand side move diagonally, nothing is there, then just move on the left hand side and there just write down number 8. Now again rule number 2, diagonally move, nothing is there, then just go down and write down number 9. So this is your magic square. In this, if you are adding all these numbers, then sum of all these numbers are same. See here, 8 plus 1, 9, and 9 plus 6, 15. Then again, 6 plus 7, 13, 13 plus 2, 15. Then again, 9 plus 2, 11, 11 plus 4, 15. 7 plus 5, 12, and 12 plus 3, 15. You see here, and as well as in the diagonally, you see that 6 plus 5, 11, 11 plus 4, 15. 8 plus 5, 13, 13 plus 2, 15. All the side, all the columns, all the rows, and all the diagonals, the sum of these all things is 15. So this is known as magic square. Let us see the next. The next one also, here we are just discussing, previously we discussing the rules regarding the square, magic square. Now here we are seeing some rules. Suppose if here I am write down number 1, then according to the rule, we have to move first rule right hand side, but here nothing is there, so just go down. So here we have to write down number 2. Then again you have to apply rule number 3. Move right hand side diagonally. Box is empty, so write down number 3. Now see here. Apply rule number first. Move diagonally. Nothing is there, then just move on left hand side. But you see here. Here already number 1 is there. So So what we have to do? Again, we have to apply rule number 3. That is, below 3, you have to write down number 4. Then again, rule number 2. Diagonally move words, nothing is there, then just go left hand side. So here in this box, we have to write down number 5. Then rule number 1st, move diagonally. So here you can see number 6. Now, here, when we move right hand side upwards, nothing is there, so we move downwards. But here already number 4 is there. So what we have to do? Rule number 3, directly we have to apply. So here we have to write down 7. Then move diagonally 8, and the last number 9 is the remaining. So just write down 9. You can see here also the sum of all these things are same. Now let us see the next one. Here in this, if we are write down 1 here, then 2, which rule we apply? Rule number 2 we are applying. Now number 3, which rule we apply? Rule number 2. Then 4, 5, 6, then again 7, 8, and 9. These all are the possible way for the magic square. It is not necessary that each row and each column, yes, it is necessary. The sum of each row and each column should be same. But in some of the cases, the sum of all the diagonals are not same. So here we are just talking about the magic square. So the sum of all the rows and sum of all the columns should be same. That is the first condition. Now see here the next one. If we are write down here number 1, then move right hand side diagonally. Again you move right hand side diagonally, but nothing is there, so just move left hand side number 3. Then when we apply rule number 2 after 3, so you can see that in that box there is number 1. So we have to apply rule number 3. Then again rule number 1. Then apply rule number 2. When you apply rule number 2 after 6, number 4 is there. So we have to write down 7, then after 8, and then after 9. These all are the maximum possible ways to complete the magic square. Now let us see the magic triangles. What is magic triangle? You can see here one triangle is there. In that, you have to write down the numbers on each side of the triangle, and the sum of each side is 9. Now in this, they also given some limitation that you have to use only the number 1 to 6 only. You have to use. So the first one, what you have to do? With the help of number 1 to 6, you have to make the pair of 3 numbers whose sum is 9. So see here, the sum of 3 plus 4, 7, 7 plus 2, 9. Now make another pair which is start from 3, but the digit is different. So 3 plus 5, 8, and 8 plus 1, 9. So you can see here in this both 3 is the common. So we have to write down 3 on the top. After that, write down 4 and 2. And then after 5 and 1. Now in the below, in the last line, you can see here, there is only number 2 and 1 is there. 2 plus 1, 3. Now which number added in 3? Then you are getting 9. So 6 minus 6 plus 3, that is the 9. So if you see here, all the sum of all the side of this triangle is 9. Let us see the another one. In this triangle, you have to write down the numbers on each side like that way. The sum of each side is 10. And here also you have to use the digits 1 to 6 only. So here you have to make some pair whose sum is 10. So here 1 plus 4, 5 and 5 plus 5, 10. Now in the second one also 1 plus 6, 7 and 7 plus 3, 10. Now the number which is common in both the pair that you have to write down on the top. And then after just arrange one number on left hand side and one number on the right hand side. So we are write down 1, 4 and 5 right hand side. Whereas we are write down 1, 6 and 3 on the left hand side. Now which number we have to write down in the middle? So see here. You have to just do the addition of 5 and 3. 5 plus 3, 8. Which number added in 8, then we are getting 10, 2. So this is your magic triangle. Now again one magic triangle is that, but you see here, there are 6 sides. There are 6 stars and among these 6 stars there is 1 circle. Now you have to put some numbers like this. See here, 5. Then 3, 7, 9, 1, 2 and 8. Can you see anything which is look like magic? You see, there is number 5 common in all the rows and in all the columns. See here, if you are doing the addition of 7 plus 5 plus 3, then it is a 15. Then 9 plus 5 plus 1, that is also 15. Then 2 plus 5 plus 8, that is also 15. Now, in this also, I am giving some numbers to you and you have to find out another numbers which is on the another side. See here, but before finding that number, I am giving one thing to you, that is the number 18. The sum of 3 numbers is 18. So 5 plus 6 plus which number added in 5 plus 6, then the sum is 18. So 5 plus 6, 11 and 11 plus 7, that is the 18. Now 4 plus 6, 10. 10 plus which number, then the sum of this 3 number is 18, that is number 8. 6 plus 3, 9. Which number added in 9? Then the sum is 18. That is number 9. So this is also one type of magic triangles. In this, you can find out the another number with the helping of some tricks. Thank you. I hope you enjoy this one and everyone understand this magic square and magic triangle. So make your own magic triangle and square.